So again, good morning. Today we will be discussing an additional topic on Presidential Decree Number 968 as amended by Republic Act Number 10707. Okay, so of course this is about the probation law. And of course, I'm your instructor, Ricardo Mariano. The contents of our topic for today, or the flow of the discussion, is we will tackle the PD 968 provisions, okay, and then we will compare it next to the provisions of Republic Act 10707, okay? But as I said earlier, many of these provisions were already discussed by Sir Alviar, but nonetheless, there are still that can be discussed with regards this amendments. Okay, so the first one we will be discussing is about Section 24. Okay, and this speaks about the miscellaneous powers of the provincial and city probation officers. So when we say miscellaneous, of course, this basically comes after, or parang ibig sabihin yan, others eh, di ba? So yung ibang kapangyarihan daw ng mga provincial and city probation officers, aside from those already discussed. Okay. And it says here that provincial or city probation officers shall have the authority within their territorial jurisdiction to administer oaths and acknowledgement and to take depositions in connection with their duties and functions under this decree. So part of the powers of a probation officer is number one, to administer oath. Ano ba yung administer oath? Okay. So whenever there are things that undertakings that needs oath, yung kailang manumpa nung kanilang mga, say for example, employees or persons, pwedeng yung probation officer yung mag-administer nun or magpagawa nung oath-taking na yun. Okay, but of course, yung oath-taking na ito should be within their jurisdiction only. Ibig sabihin, dapat related lang sa probation program nila. Of course, kung oath-taking yan, say for example, oath-taking ng criminology, pwede ba nilang gawin yun? Of course not, because that is not part of their jurisdiction. Okay? They can also conduct acknowledgements. Ano naman yung acknowledgement? Ito yung mga pwede silang gumawa at mag-certify ng documents na nagpapatunay na yung isang tao, ginawa niya yung isang bagay. Okay? Again, these acknowledgements must be within their jurisdiction, meaning ayun, about sa probation lang yung pwede nilang i-acknowledge. Kung may ibang acts na ginawa yung tao na wala namang relationship sa probation program, then there can be no acknowledgements. Okay? Excuse me. So, they can also take depositions. Depositions naman are like testimonies, written testimonies. So, pwede rin. Basta again, dapat in relation to their probation. Okay? Yes, ano yan?
So, hindi po namin makita yung sa ano, sa PowerPoint, hindi po lumilipat sa screen. Nandun pa rin po siya sa introduction.
No, nasa introduction pa din. Okay.
Yung pong binabasa niyo, sir, hindi po siya nag-a-upper sa screen namin.
Okay. So, what can be the problem? Paano kaya ito? Mm-hmm. So, hindi pa naglilipat.
Ayan, sir, okay na po.
Okay na? Ah, sige. So, let's try, ah. Pag ganito, nakita nyo na o hindi pa rin?
Yan sir po, okay na po. Nandun na po siya sa section 24.
Okay. Pati yung laman niya, nakikita nyo na?
Opo sir.
Okay, good. So di bale, yung mga nauna naman, introduction, sumunod contents, tapos eto na. Wala na nga, wala. Hindi naman ganun ka-importante. Okay? And lastly, they also have the power with respect to their probationers, the powers of police officers. Okay, so kumbaga, yun nga, we can consider these probation officers parang yun, they have the power when it comes to their probationers, okay, yung tawag sa kanila, yung mga undergoing probation, and they have the police power over them. And when we say police power, ano ba yung mga powers of the police natin, di ba? They have the power to enforce the law, to maintain peace and order and the like. But if we apply it to probation, of course, they have the control over the probationers. Okay? They can enforce the law on the probationers. So yan yung mga dagdag na kapangyarihan ng provincial and City Probation Officers. I already marked it in red para mas madaling ma-identify, administration of oath, acknowledgements, depositions, and the power of the police officer. Okay, now we go to Republic Act 10707. Can you guys see it also? Nakikita pa rin ba?
Wala pa po, sir.
Medyo mabagal. Oh, sige. Nonetheless, sige. Ito. Yan, nakikita na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay na po.
So, kailangan ata binaback muna para makita nyo. Okay, but nonetheless, sige, ganun na lang gawin natin. Excuse me. Yan. So, this is the amendment provided by Republic Act 10707. So, of course, it amend Section 24, but it is Section 4 of the new law. Okay? And basically, ang dinagdag niya lang naman dito is the regional probation officer. So kung dati, provincial and city probation officers lang yung may power ng administration of oath, taking of depositions, acknowledgements, and power of the police, ngayon kasama na yung regional probation officer. Okay? Also, dinagdag nila, they shall be officers, probation officers from the region, province, and city, they are considered as persons in authority. Okay? If we were to recall, what are persons in authority, di ba? These are persons in charge with the enforcement of law in their jurisdiction. It is different from the so-called agents of a person in authority, wherein they are the ones to assist the person in authority in implementing such laws. Ngayon, kung titignan natin kasi yung kanina sa PD 968, makikita natin na parang police power ang meron yung ano, or powers of a police officer, meron ang isang probation officer. And kapag sinabi mo kasing powers of the police, if again we were to recall our previous topics, police officers are agents of a person in authority. Okay, ibig sabihin sila yung tumutulong lang sa mga persons in authority. Okay? And who are these persons in authority? Again, persons vested with authority such as the barangay captains, the mayors, the governors, those are the persons in authority. Ngayon, not necessarily na magkasing taas na sila, pero they have the same authority or power with those. Etong mga probation officers, they are not just like police officers na agents of a person in authority, they are actually persons in authority themselves. Okay? Being yun nga, they have the power, of course, when it comes to their probationers or when it comes to probation program. Okay? They are persons in authority. Sir, what is the essence of distinguishing between persons in authority and agents of a person in authority? Of course, one of its significance is that when it comes to laws applicable, okay? For example, if we try to hurt or attack an agent or a person in authority, their crimes will not be the same, correct? One will be direct assault, one will be indirect assault. So one will have a higher penalty, one will have a lower one. So that is why is a need to identify whether a person is a person in authority or just an agent. Okay? So yan. Yan ang sinabi ni RA 10707. Kung kanina, power of the police officer, ngayon, parang let's say, parang na-promote. Okay? Because they are now persons in authority. Okay? So ang gawin ko, i-back natin siya para makita nyo ulit. And then let's proceed with another slide. Okay, so I presume nakikita nyo. Kung hindi, magsabi lang. So we go to another... Okay, good. So we go to another provision of PD 968 or the probation law or the adult probation law. And in section 28, it says here, probation aides. Okay, probation aides were hired by virtue of this law to assist the provincial or city probation officers in the supervision of probationers. The probation administrator may appoint citizens of good repute and probity to act as probation aides. Of course, when we hear the word aid, parang yan yung mga tumutulong. Okay? So these probation aids, yan yung mga tumutulong sa mga probation officers in the conduct of the probation programs. Okay, of course, they are also persons who help probation officers para yun, para makatulong ma-rehabilitate yung isang offender. Okay? And in this section, it provides for what are the qualifications of a probation aid. And medyo simple lang, good repute and probity. When we say good repute, Tagalogin nyo lang yan, magandang reputasyon. Kumbaga, he is seen by the community as a good person, hindi siya nakikita, wala siyang bad record, kumbaga, sa community. Okay? He is of good repute and probity. Pag sinabi mo namang probity, it's a combination of integrity, honesty, morality. Yan, hindi siya, yun nga, he is honest, hindi siya nakukorap, hindi siya involved sa mga immoral acts or situations and the like. Yun lang, basta meron siya nun. Okay, a citizen who is reputable, who is morally qualified, if you may, yan, pwede siyang maging probation aid. Okay? Now, let's go to the next one. There is the continuation of such a provision, and that is about the compensation. Pag ikaw ay aid, okay, sabi niya dito, you shall not receive any regular compensation. So, hindi ito regular na employment o trabaho. Okay? Hindi siya katulad ng yun, teaching, ng being a police officer, jail officer, na meron tayong regular payment or salary. Dito, walang regular compensation. However, for their services, they can be given reasonable travel allowance. Yun lang, pamasahe. Okay? Although, of course, sino ba naman ang mag-volunteer kung pamasahe lang, di ba? And of course, be that as it may, there are of course chances na yung travel allowance medyo nag-i-exceed ng konti. Kasi, let's say for example, saan ba yung probation office natin? If I'm not mistaken, our PPA is above the office of the Regional Trial Court in Tarlac. So let's say taga Maliwalo ka. Yun ay nasa San Vicente, dadaan ka lang ng 3M, di ba? 3M, sakay ka lang ng 3M. Dati 9 pesos or 8 pesos, ngayon 15 na dahil may pandemic. So kung balikan ka lang, let's say 15 pesos, 30 pesos. So parang would that be 30 pesos lang yung ano, yung ibibigay sa iyo per day? Okay, every time na tumulong ka as a probation aid, of course, that would be very, ewan ko ha, for me, hindi siya masyadong kaaya-aya kung travel allowance lang yung ibibigay sa'yo. Okay, but nonetheless, that is what is written in the law. Okay, travel allowance only. Also, the probation aid shall hold office for such period as may be determined by the probation administrator. Yun lang. Yung pagiging probation aid natin, nakadepende yan kay probation administrator. Kumbaga, pag sabi niyang, tama na, okay na siya, wag na siyang maging probation officer, tapos na. Okay, kumbaga, nakadepende sa isang tao yung pagiging probation officer mo. Or probation aid, I should say. And then, the qualifications and maximum caseloads shall be provided in the rules promulgated pursuant to this decree. So I think there were mention of these rules in the video of Sir Alviar. So the qualifications, yun, dun daw natin makikita. Okay, and I will discuss it later, yung qualifications naman. Even the maximum caseloads. Caseloads meaning ilan yung pwedeng hawakan mong probationers. Okay, di ba? Under the principle of, ano yun, sa LEA, yung span of control, di ba? Dapat ang ipapahawak lang sa yung kaso or tao is yung kaya mong i-manage. Ganon din dito. Hindi naman pwedeng isang probation aid, bigay mo lahat sa kanya ng probationer, di baka hindi rin siya nakatulong, hindi rin siya nakapag-focus sa mga offenders, ayun, wala rin na-rehabilitate. Kaya dapat may, may maximum number lang kung ilan yung pwede niyang hawakang kaso. Okay? So, X, and then let's now go to the Provisions of Republic Act 1070 and 7. So, Section 6 naman ng batas na ito, ng bagong batas, yung nag-amend sa Section 28. At ang sabi niya, Yan, volunteer probation assistant. So bago na yung term ano, hindi na siya probation aids. Ang tawag na sa kanila ay volunteer probation assistants or VPAs. Okay? Their job is the same, to assist the chief probation and parole officer in the supervised treatment program of the probationer. So, medyo nabago rin pala dito yung pangalan ng boss, pero nonetheless, siya pa rin naman yun. Okay? Probation and parole officer na yung tawag kasi ang office na nila is the PPA nga. Okay? The Parole and Probation Administration. And then, the probation administrator is still the and may appoint citizens of good repute and probity. So, nandun pa rin yun, yung good repute and probity. Pero nandirito na yung tinatawag natin ngayong qualifications. Okay? Or additional okay qualifications. And that those are willingness, aptitude, and capability to act as VPAs. Of course, willingness is the volunteerism. Kaya nga nakalagay na dyan yung volunteer. Okay? Willingness, hindi lang sila napipilitan. Okay? They have the aptitude, okay, aptitude or the mindset or the intellect, okay, to be a probation assistant. Hindi naman kasi pwedeng kahit sino lang pwede. Dapat, alam niya, dapat kaya niya. Or na hindi niya kaya, he is willing to learn, okay. And then we have capability or much more leaning to the skills. Kung yung aptitude, medyo sa pag-iisip, sa kakayahan, sa intellect niya, ito sa skills naman niya. Okay. Sa ano bang skills ang kailangan kapag ikaw ay magiging probation assistant or volunteer probation assistant? Of course, here you will be dealing with offenders. So, dapat hindi kayong, of course, number one, hindi ka dapat natatakot sa kanila. Okay? You must be able, aside from talking to people, admit it or not, ibang klaseng tao yung mga yan because they are, yun nga, offenders. So, iba rin dapat yung approach mo sa kanila from ordinary persons. Okay? So, may mga ganong kailangan na capable tayo, kumbaga kaya nating gawin for us to be admitted as a volunteer probation assistant or VPA. Okay? Next. In addition to that, so VPA shall not receive any regular compensation still. Katulad ng kanina, wala pa rin silang regular payment dahil volunteers nga sila. Okay, pero again, nandoon pa rin yung transportation allowances. Pero ang kagandahan, meron ng bago, meron na ring meal allowance. Yan. So aside sa pamasahe, bibigyan ka na ng pang-ambula, no? Okay, or bibigyan ka na ng pang-meal allowance. Dito, ito yung maganda kasi dito mo siya pwedeng ma-adjust. Kasi pag sinabi mo ang transportation, madali lang ma-determine. Eh. 3M, 15-15, 30, tapos. Eh, itong meal allowance, magkakano ba yung meal? Of course, hindi mo naman pwedeng sabihin na, oh, dapat ambula, 35 lang yan. Okay? Pwede mong sabihin na, oh, ang meal allowance mo ay, let's say, Chowking. Sabi mo, Chowking Laureate. Oh, di mga nasa 170 yun, di ba? 169, oh. Di may 200 na siya. Oh, so, pwedeng medyo mas laruin. So, it would be a bit better. Okay, na meron ng transpo and meal allowance. Okay? Nonetheless, it will be determined by a probation administrator. Okay? And yun, last or next slides. So, huli kayanin pa ng laptop. And sige. To be sure, let me just put in my charger ano, for a while. So we are back. Let's go back to the discussion. Hopefully, if you can see it. If not, just tell me so. 10.07. Ah, tama. Continuation of the rules on the VPAs. So they shall hold office for a two-year term, which may be renewed or recalled anytime for a just cause. Okay, meaning, yung kanina, ang pangit, tama bang tabi nating pangit? Or ang hindi maganda, dun sa PD 968 ay nakasalalay kay probation administrator kung gaano katagal yung ano, yung isang probation aid. Kumbaga, kapag ganun kasi na ultimately under the control of a person, aminin natin sa hindi, prone yung corruption, yung tipong konting siko-siko para either ikaw ay maging probation of aid ng napakatagal. Walang limit, kumbaga. Okay? Pero ngayon, ang kagandahan, meron ng limit. 2-year term. Okay? Yun na yung maximum, ordinarily, or generally. 2 years lang pwedeng maging volunteer probation assistants. Pero it can be renewed. Okay? Pwedeng, sige, pagkatapos mo ng 2 years, tuloy mo na kasi magaling ka naman eh. Or pwede rin recall. Nag 2 years ka, nag-stop ka, tapos tatawagin ka ulit. Okay? But this must be for a just cause. Dapat may magandang dahilan. So isa pa yun. Isa pa yung magandang provision ng law na hindi pwedeng dahil gusto ka lang ni probation administrator ay makukuha ka na. Hindi. There must be a just cause. Meaning, malamang sa malamang, may mga hinawakan kang probationer and then na-reform naman sila, hindi naman na sila nag repeat offense. Okay, kaya yun. May just cause. Magaling ka kasi na probation assistant or volunteer probation assistant. Their functions and qualifications, eto, continuance in office, maximum caseload shall be further prescribed under the implementing rules and regulations of this act. Okay, so yung functions, qualifications, generally, yung functions, yung kanina, yung assisting the probation or chief probation and parole officers, yun yung general. Yung specific functions niya pa, and even the qualifications, maximum caseloads, I think that's part of the discussions pa nung ating module. Okay? So, hindi ko na itatackle yun kasi I think madi-discuss naman. Okay? So, as not to be a repetition. Okay? Ang dinagdag dito, yun nga, continuance of office or the, yun, pagpapatuloy dun sa kanyang trabaho as a VPA will be all under the implementing rules and regulations or the IRR na sinasabi ni Sir Alviar last time. Okay? And of course, sabi ko nga, they will be discussed in the future kaya I will not tackle them anymore. Okay. Makita nyo, still continuation, there shall be a reasonable number of VPAs in every regional, provincial, and city probation office. Whenever you see the word reasonable, case-to-case basis yan, okay, or reasonable number. Hindi ka pwede kasi magsabi ng 10, ng 5, ng 20, reasonable. Pag sinabi mong reasonable, it depends on the case. In this case, it depends upon the place. No, nakadepende kung marami bang probationers sa Tarlac. Kung maraming probationers sa Tarlac, then the reasonable number of VPA dapat madami din. Pero kung konti ang probationers sa Tarlac, the reasonable number is dapat konti din. Ganun ang ibig sabihin ng reasonable. It's case-to-case basis. Hindi ka pwedeng mag-impose ng minimum 10, maximum 10, hindi. What is reasonable in this situation will prevail. Okay? And then, in order to strengthen the functional relationship of the VPAs and probation administrator, the latter or the probation administrator shall encourage and support the former to organize themselves in the national, regional, provincial, and city levels for effective utilization, coordination, and sustainability of the volunteer program. So, of course, for reading pleasure na lang ito, para daw, yeah, para maganda yung relationship ng VPA, probation administrator. Yan, basta support lang sila within with each other, kumbaga. Okay? So let's proceed next. Ayun, I think that's that. Unless there are questions, you may ask them now. If none, I will be the one to ask you a question on a quiz. Okay? So may tanong ba? Anyone? O ano yun? Natulugan nyo na ba ako? Are there questions? Miss President, are there questions? Ayun,
sir,
since Anan, sige. Pero I think, thank you, Miss Garcia. Pero I think may nagtataas ng kamay. Sige, entertain natin. Si Nina, wala. Pero kayo nagtataas. Ayun, Resueño, ano yung gusto nating itanong?
Sir, tanong ko lang kung anong 13 provision, sir, yung sinabi ni Sir Albiar, sir, about dun sa PD 968 na inamend ng 10707, sir, yung pag-apply ng provision. Di ba, sir, dun sa previous law, kailangan mamili nung petitioner if kung gusto niya mag-appeal or mag-apply for probation. Pero sa 10707, sir, sinabi kapag na-mitigate yung penalty niya or yung imprisonment niya na pumasok doon sa qualification ng PD 968, pwede daw siya mag-apply, sir, sa probation. Anong section yun, sir?
Okay. So I think, yes, that was mentioned in the discussion of Sir Albiar. Ngayon, as to the sections, sadly, no, hindi ko kabisado lahat ng sections na yan. Pero a quick rundown of the law, madali lang yan makita. Sige. So if we were to open PD 1077, madali lang yan, just in case. Okay. Let's just go to the law itself. Sige. Although, yun nga, honestly, ano, although law student tayo, hindi tayo ganun ka kagaling mag-memorize. Ito, in section 1 ng 10707, pero yun nga, dahil inamend niya yung PD 968, makikita mo siya sa section 4 on grant of probation.
Okay.
So doon natin siya makikita.
Okay? Thank you, sir.
Yes, good question. Pero pa ba?
None, sir.
Wala na? Okay. So, there being none, thank you very much. We will now be ending this recording in 1, 2, 3.